Good morning. I think the sound should be better now, or the microphone sound. I went back and listened a little bit to yesterday's, and I was like, "What the fuck is wrong with my?" It's like overfeeding, and it's just crazy. And I realized this is one of the reasons I hate getting a new computer, and you have to like download all this other shit. I also noticed on OBS that like it didn't save all of my background drops. On Wondershare, I lost all of my transitions that I favorited, and all that other stuff that I spent hours creating is just not able to be passed over for some reason. So I was went back and listened to it, and I was like realizing that because I had uploaded this OBS, for some reason, it wasn't reading my microphone as the default, and it was putting the stupid camera micro default, which is why it was like sounding like shit the whole time. So I think we've got that fixed. So you let me know if the voice sounds like shit still, because I pretty much went in there and made sure that it was working. But yo, what's up, reactions? Good to see you back. Looks like we got all the people, the Rugrats, everybody, a part of the group that's always here is here. I need to go through this real quick. I know since you guys hear this every once in a while, you're gonna have to hear it again because in the good news, in the last week, we've had two people turn in songs or sets to the channel, which are new. And we always like new people doing it, as long as it doesn't get out of hand. I don't think it ever will. These two people didn't know like how to do it, so I need to go over it real quick for you new people who are just maybe joining the channel and you want to turn in a set or songs. This is how you're going to do it, because they did it wrong, and so I want to make sure, because if they do it wrong, I have to go back, send them an email, and kind of like tell them how to do it in case they do it in the future. So to try to avoid that a little bit, that's why I'm going through this real quick. So if you are new and you have never turned in a set or a song, because look, if you look to the, I guess my left, your right, it's $7 per song. So if you're going to turn in like five songs, that'd be $35. The very first thing you need to do is send that money to my PayPal account, which is that email address, willtolive2004@yahoo. Once you send the money, the very next thing you need to do is send me an email. This is separate. This is after. Send me an email to that exact same address, willtolive2004@yahoo. And in that email, you need to have this exact example. Because Jean-Francois did a great job at doing this, and I think he's like, there's a couple that do a really good job. You need to put the link. So you're going to list the song, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, however many songs you're listing. I do have a limit of about an hour, so your music should be no more than 40 minutes, unless you're going to pay $50 for a whole album, which could be 60 minutes, but even then, that's kind of pushing it. So you're going to put basically the band and then their song. You don't have to put what time, how long it is, unless you want to. Make sure you put the link so that when I download it, I'm downloading what you told me to download, and you can't blame me for picking something wrong. Because I've done that in the past where I've picked things that were wrong and it sounded like crap, and then they were like, "You picked the wrong song." Not my fault. Okay, so put the link in there. I will download it and then I will put it on there. And then just a little snippet about why you picked the song, what any details about the song lyrically, or just something you want us to know in the chat. After you've done that, send that to me, and then we'll find a day for you to have your set list or your songs played. And then we will go from there. So, if you have any questions, write me an email at willtolive2004@yahoo.com and let me know. And I will let you know how to do something if you don't know how to do it. But this is what we are doing. You know what? As a consolation thing, if you want to put an extra $3 in, I'll do a shot of Captain Morgan Rum too. Or if you do an extra dollar, you can tell me to answer a question immediately, which is a great segue into the next point before we get into Michael's set. Is. On Monday, since nobody turned in a set, I decided that we could just have a question and answer time. So if you go to the community tab, which I'm going to show you right here. So if you go to, first you need to subscribe, you should subscribe. And then once you go there, if you look and you see community, I've circled it in red, click on community. And when you click on community, it will take you to this post that I just posted yesterday after the set. Go in there. If you have any questions you want me to answer, list them there. Thank goodness. The last time I did this, I think a couple people asked questions, but that was it. This time, we can do a whole hour set of just Baggins questions because he literally left like 30 questions. So Baggins, when you listen to this, I love it. Thank you. I appreciate it. I think that's great. I would answer all of them. But in case I can't get to all of them, can you like take out of those 30 questions and pick your top five and reply in that thread and just like pick the top five so that I know to get to those top five no matter what? And then if we have time, because nobody else asks questions, then we'll get to those other 25. So do that by tomorrow or by Monday night, so that when we come here tomorrow night, I'll try to answer some questions. I might also ask you guys some questions. So don't just think that you're going to be asking me questions the whole time. I might be asking you guys some follow-up questions, okay? All right, so we got through that. Let's get to Michael Sett, who is always got some good, tasty, elegant, raw, lingerie-ridden. And I'm hoping there's another one of those. There probably will be. So... all right, thanks, Jean-Francois, for your questions as well. Great, Ryan's back, and we are ready to start. So let's get into Baggins, or not Baggins, Michael Hermanset. Sorry, Baggins, you're on my mind. It says, hey, Cap, decided to do another set list after mulling ideas for a bit, so here it goes. All right, this first song, I think we all should know if you don't. Well, you might not know this exact version of it, but this is Johnny B. Goode, great song. It's a cover by Frank Marino. Just figured it would be a good. It would be good to hear from Frank again. I also thought this, I think it's Rusing version of the old classic, would be a good party starter. Saw Frank in an interview saying it's one of his favorites to play and usually does it in every concert. There's a middle part he throws in that sounds like some old tune but can't quite place it. So maybe you music elites will know what it is. Maybe someone else can. So here we go with Johnny B. Goode, cover by Frank Marino. Are we ready? Let's do it. Like a Petrucci lick. I said people gonna come to see you play. Is it Frozen? Maybe gonna dig on you anyway. Yes. Yeah, he's got like Adrian, I agree. He's got like a raspy voice. Is the level of my voice comparable to the music? Too loud, too soft? Ooh, that was a nice da-na-na-na-na-na. Could have been a little tighter, but it's live, so... a little loud, okay. There we go. yeah, that's. Yeah, this is. Steve's fucking going off. It is a good song to go off to, though. Yeah, this is like shredding Johnny B. Good. Although, fair play to Michael J. Fox. He did a good job at going off in his version, but his was at the end. Which, by the way, greatest trilogy of all time. Like Good Will Hunting. You can't disagree. Ooh. Yeah, I would agree, Ryan. This is a fantastic version of this song. I love it. I wouldn't call it a dumb question, but because I don't know either. This is like a fucking clinic in guitar. Yes. Chuck Berry. Yeah, Adrian, there's this thing called Google. I hate when people say that. It's like, yeah. If you want me to only interact with Google, then sure. I'm asking you, a fucking human being, a question. Suck my dick now, because I'm so good. Thank you. All right, that was a great fucking way to start out the set. I mean, wow. I would almost call that not a cover. Because it was more of a guitar solo than it was Johnny B. Good. I mean, I think Johnny B. Good was maybe sung twice, the chorus, and then everything else was just like a guitar rip you in the face with my big shlong. Yeah, I don't even know if we could call that a cover, guys. I mean, that was a guitar clinic that sang Johnny B. Good chorus twice. So, I don't know if that was a cover, so it needs to be reframed. All right, so I did want to mention this because... before we get to the next song, before this stream started, so when I bought this new computer, one of the things they talked about was the Wi-Fi that's in it is supposed to be really good. And that was news to me because it shows you how little I know about computer internals. I thought a Wi-Fi card is just a Wi-Fi card, just allows Wi-Fi. But supposedly, according to the dude, there's certain Wi-Fi abilities depending on what's in your computer that make it easier or the channel better to get better Wi-Fi. I didn't know. I don't know. And I don't even know if that's still true. That's what he told me. Maybe he was just trying to make me buy a better Wi-Fi internal. But either way, I will say before this started, I did a test. I did two different tests to see how fast the internet was. And on the download speed was twice as fast as I've ever seen in the past. It was twice as fast. The upload speed was just a little bit faster. So there's definitely something going on. So I don't know if it's it's gotta be the Wi-Fi because I've never seen those numbers before until I got this computer and did my first test. Which brings me to point number two. During that whole song, I was looking down at the Wi-Fi connection, and it's green when you got like a good connection. Like it says right now, I have an excellent connection. It's green. Almost throughout that whole song, it was red, which is why it froze. and it was like between yellow and red almost the whole song. Very little of it was it green. That means this is a YouTube issue. Remember, I was asking you guys about this. I was like, is this my connection issue or is this a YouTube issue? Because I just don't understand how there's so many dropped frames and so many connection issues. But with having twice as fast download and about a little bit more upload speed, which the upload speed is the most important with this kind of live stream stuff, there is no reason it should be red the whole fucking time. So YouTube, I don't know why you're making it so difficult, but stop. Jeez. What up, Manuel Romero? Anyway, let's get to number two. Number two is the title track from A Farewell to Kings by Rush. Okay, I don't know if I know the title. I don't know the order. I do know the album. Lyrics are very apropos to... See, I know how to say that. Apropos to today's... Why are you trying to use big words, motherfucker? Lyrics are very apropos to today's times, for sure. Although, always thought this was one of their better efforts in songwriting. The classical guitar part in the beginning is gorgeous. The explosion into the song. Good chorus and the guitar solo break. Well, I still can't figure out the meter, and Neil's drumming and Geddy's bass behind Alex are fantastic as usual. Also love how they transitioned back to the opening theme, so smooth. I wonder how many of you guys have heard this one, including Cap. Never got any radio play. If it didn't, I probably haven't heard it. All right, so here we go. Let's do A Farewell to Kings by Rush. I don't think I know this song. I think I need to turn that up. See, immediately it's red. Immediately the connection's fucking red, and it was just green. I think it has something to do. I think it has something to do with it trying to figure out what the song is for their fucking dumb copyright bullshit. Dude, I've got it turned all the way up. The router was a $350 router, so I don't think it's the router. It's Aris. It's supposed to be a really good one. Okay, so I'm gonna bust in. Still not that loud. Look at Michael always coming in with the ancient recordings that I have to constantly adjust. This doesn't sound familiar to me. The recording makes it sound like a high school band. Even in the bad recording. Beating down the mountain to land, scoffing at the wife. But I think it's funny because nobody else would get away with that. It's because it's Rush that it's charming that the sound sounds like this. If it's a band you don't love, this is a very familiar. I choose free will. It's almost the same chorus. The minds that made us wrong. Oh, can we lie? That first part sounded like I choose free will. What's wrong? Peace out, Pear. Be safe. Yeah, this is Michael shredding set list. Yeah, great, Adrian. I like that. A nice little slowdown. Wow. Okay, I think we're back. We're back. Dude, this is crazy. I'm telling you, my internet's good. I don't understand. I'm telling you, I think this is a YouTube issue. This is a YouTube issue. My internet's fine. So, yeah, my internet's working on every other web page I open. This is definitely a YouTube issue. I think it's annoying. Oh my lord. We might have to quit. We might have to quit this stream, you guys. If it keeps doing this, I don't know what else we can do. yeah, let's try to... let's see, looks like... Hello? Yeah, farewell to stream. What the heck? You guys, I'm telling you, my internet, I just opened up two other pages. This is definitely a YouTube issue. So, I can try to keep going. Yeah, I think people are here, or at least a few people are here. I don't know how to reconnect to the... Let's try that. Okay. Let's give it a try and see how far we can make it. So, oh, this is so annoying. Like, this should not be an issue. All right, so we're going to move on to number three. It says, decided to revisit Conum. I think it's Conum? Conum? I can't remember how to say it. For two more songs. So this is interesting, Michael. Like, you're pretty picky with musicians, but I think once you find a group or a musician, i.e. Astanova, you, like, really focus in on them. Is that kind of your personality, or is this just kind of an unusual quirk? Hoping maybe if we keep shitting on their singer, they'll fire him and become the band I know they can be. It's pretty funny. Yeah, I know, fat chance. But again, found these two songs worthy of a listen by the group. Sure to evoke different opinions. Oh, so that means we're going to be having some arguments here. So this first one's called As the Waters Rise. Several pointed this out on the last song we heard that they've got a happy vibe, which I find refreshing. So many metal songs have a dark feel. I felt some of the guitar parts in the beginning part of the song channel, Steely Dan's Reeling in the Eaves. I don't know that song. In general, I'm impressed with the guitarist's contributions to each song. He does a lot and it sounds good. While I dislike the singer, he does have a good range. I find the guitar solo is very melodic as opposed to just sounding like he's practicing scales like some shredders do. And this is a long one. This is a 9-minute song, according to Michael. So let's get into it. Number three. Has a Rush vibe at the beginning of this. It is kind of low. Let me turn it up. There we go. Oh, yes. So far, Michael, I think everyone likes the beginning. Kind of want to go to wherever that is. Although, the slavery kind of.
I gave myself in the prayer so long forgotten.
Yeah, that slavery background's a little suspect. Yeah, Ryan, I think because of the singer, right? He's got that Mars Volta sound. It could be, Scott, but looks a little suspect. Honestly, his voice is not, like, so bad that I can't dig the rest of the music. Building here. Yeah, even with his voice, I get what people are saying, but I don't mind it all that much. Yes. Yeah, I definitely. Adrian, that's right. Like, it's not great, but it's better than what we heard before. Again, could you imagine, like, being this band and coming to be like, hey, someone did a reaction to our song, let's go listen to it. And consistently, everyone just keeps saying, oh, the singer's not that good. And you're the singer, like, listening to it, like, hearing that. That'd be a tough swallow. Ashley. Ooh. That's a nice little scale there. Ooh. Ooh. Dude, the musicianship in this is really good. Like, this song is on the brink of going on a playlist for me. But again, could you imagine being a singer and hearing everybody be like, yeah, the singer's not good, but the band is great. That would be tough. Hear that, like, in the background. Okay, one more time, Michael. Is it Ka, like Omicron, or is it Ko, like as in Ko? Is it Konum or Kanum? Ooh, listen to that bass. It looks like Kana, because it looks Greek, and if it's Greek, it's an ah sound. Omicron. Omicron. Ah sound. Yeah, I could see it being Konum too. Ko. Ooh. Great bass run there with the guitar. It's always funny to me when people talk about the, you know, disease variant, and they go Omicron. It's like Omicron. Kona? Kona. Where you put the stress too. See, that's the thing, Adrian, like, I think the singing has got to match a singer with your musicianship is the hardest part of making. I think it's the big difference between, like, a bad band to an okay band to a really great band. It's this front man. The front man is really huge. He can even be a good singer, but if he doesn't fit the style or whatever, it's just a lost cause. Yeah, this is a great song. I will probably put this on a playlist. I like the feeling of it. Song title was As the Waters Rise. All right. So, yeah, I'm pretty digging that song. Like, I wouldn't say it was the best song ever or anything like that, but it certainly, yeah, certainly was a well-crafted song, and I don't think his singing was in that song bad enough for me to, like, be turned off by it. So, yeah, I think that'll go onto a playlist. So, thanks, Michael. And as I said, and I will repeat it again, you know, even when I would write music, like, from high school, I remember I wrote the bass part and the guitar part. I just could never, like, the hardest part of writing a song for me was the melody, vocals, and even if you write a melody with vocals that fits, you gotta have the right toned singer sing it, or it sounds bad. And I would try to sing it, and I fucking suck. So it just would ruin the song. So, like, I always, you know, like, if you have, you know, a good, like, again, if you take a band like Between the Buried Me and you just switch out the singer, I think you're automatically better. Except when he does his, like, you know, non-harsh stuff. And then, like, if you imagine Metallica without James Hetfield, I don't think they would be nearly as iconic. They just wouldn't be. His voice is very iconic. It's like the front man is the most important part, and also the most annoying part, because a lot of front men just tend to be annoying and narcissistic, but that's part of what makes them good. So, yeah, I mean, it's really tough to find a good singer that matches. That, again, they can be a fantastic singer individually, but for them to match your style and to match the ability to do what the band wants to do, that's a really tough fit. It's a really tough thing to find. So, all right, let's get on to the next one, which is also Konam, however we want to say it, Konam. maybe they need to come on here and listen to this and tell us how to pronunciate their name. This one's called Biotundra. Wait. Byrotundra, yeah, Tunda. There's no R there. That's kind of weird. It's wait, B. Is it Byrotunda? Byrotunda. Again, what the fuck is up with their weird names that you don't know how to pronunciate? It's Birotunda. I thought I saw tundra, Biotundra, but it's Byrotunda. Okay. Guitar. Again, seems to mimic some funky, '70s guitar parts here. There is a section in the middle with a short guitar solo into a keyboard solo, then a unison guitar keyboard run into a pretty awesome guitar solo. Sweet. Sounds like very progressive. Really like the whole part. They then go into a halftime section that I'm sure I will like, that yes, I probably will. I'll probably end up doing more off their album, but this is it for today. This is a 7:20 song, so let's get to it.
You and I have come so far, paid the price of building on earth a paradise.
By the coming eyes that I have worn to draw outside the light,
through the misery and war,
by Rebrandt
and vision.
I don't like the singing here. Like this. I didn't like the singing in the opening there. Yes. Yes. Yeah, I hear that funky bit that you're talking about, Michael. That was a bad attempt at sounding like Heiner. Hey Ryan, that's probably why Michael likes this, because it's very Rush sounding. The chords. Yeah, see, he's back to sounding not that good on this song. Nice, there's the halftime. Oh God, Ryan, how dare you? That's blasphemy. James is not that bad, dude. Come on. Yeah, it is. The music is really, really good. Transitions that Michael was talking about. Keyboard run. And... Ooh, yes. Very tasty guitar here. Nice. The music is so good in the song. Listening to this, just no, no. That was a fucking huge no. Oh my God. That dude was like, that was so bad. It was almost like he was making that face when he was doing it, thinking it was going to come out good. Just like that. think it's like he gets, because like this right here is not great, it's not bad, but that one section, it was almost like he was thinking in his head, like, dude, I'm gonna fucking rip this to shreds. And it was like the opposite. It was almost like the higher version of those people who go on American Idol thinking that they're good and they're not. That choice right there was, woo. Yeah, that choice. When he did that, I was just like, what was, and I don't do that very often. I just don't do that. I mean, it's kind of like, yeah, I don't prefer it, but that was that one little, it was fucking terrible, bro. If you're listening to this, don't ever do that again. Just, I would even go back to the studio and redo that take and just be like, okay, I was wrong there. I accept it and I'm going to redo it. But the song was good. Again, those I really like. What's funny is it's very similar to Between the Buried and Me. Like, musically, they're fantastic. But the singer, this singer is nowhere near as bad as that singer for Between the Buried and Me. Like, I can listen to this and just be like, yeah, I don't prefer it, but I can get past it. Between the Buried and Me, I just cannot get past it. It's just, unless he's only singing, like, clean vocals. All right, so we are at 55 minutes, mostly because of this stupid stream going down. Finally, a happy ending from Lola. Is it like a real one? Because I would certainly love it. Here she plays the Fantasy Impromptu by Frédéric Chopin. Actually, while she's still hot, this is not a sexploitation video. Well, come on, Michael, what are we here for? Just a nice dress and a video that is mostly showing her playing the tune. Besides everything else about her, she has lots of videos of pieces my dad used to play, so it's a bit of a trip down memory lane for me too, though I doubt my dad would approve of her outfits. Is your dad conservative? This is another difficult tune in the piano literature because it requires great technicality, but also needs to express the beauty in the melodies. As my dad used to say, anyone can play the notes. It's what you do with those notes that matter. That translates to guitar, drums, everything. Well, she does a great job here too. I know in terms of technique, she's par for the course for concert pianists, but I really think her interpretations are excellent. That's interesting. So when it comes to piano, obviously I can tell the technique of someone who's really, really good, but I'm not good enough or know piano enough to know if somebody's like in the groove. Like, you know, in drums, I can feel when somebody's in the groove and when they're not, or when they're kind of in the groove. I would not be able to tell that with piano. So I'm going to trust your word that she's got like that groove and that feeling with the stuff. So he says, so there you guys go, around 30, 35 minutes of music, but it's a lot longer because the stupid stream went down. I want to thank Cap and everyone in the group for doing their sets and listening to mine. I look forward to our get-togethers. I've got some hard stuff going on in life right now, and it's nice to have some fun and take my mind off of it. That is the ticket, man. And I love that I would actually, again, this is just a throwing out there a possibility. If one day we could all meet in a similar place, maybe at a concert together, we find a band that we all can handle enough that we are not so turned off. Like, I would never go to a Between the Buried and Me concert, so that's out. I'm sure Ryan would never go to a Dream Theater concert, so that's out. But if we can find a band that we all don't mind going to see, maybe we can meet up someday. That'd be kind of cool. So anyway, let's get to the song. And let's see if Astanova gives me a semi. That's a good start. I have to say, and I told you this, Michael, on my own, I don't like some of her antics in other videos on YouTube when she's got like one knee on the seat and she's kind of like leaning into it. It's like, not my thing. This is okay. Yeah, oh, Hagen, speaking of, I need to buy my tickets for that still. Ryan, that's great to hear too. Michael, when you say that her technique is just par for the course, like how would I be able to tell that? Because like to me, she's doing a lot of runs that I would consider pretty difficult, but I guess all classical pianists can do that kind of stuff. Whereas I don't think most pianists can do the runs that Jordan Rudess does, which is why I can see why he's above the rest in a lot of ways. But she seems good to me. And again, I wouldn't be able to tell. And there are so many classic pianists out there. What about this song do you like too, Michael? Fantastic legs, which is why they're focusing on them. Michael, I don't know. Have you seen the individual stuff that he does? He was trained classical first. I don't know if you can say that without seeing some of his classical. Again, I wouldn't be able to be like the final denoter of that, but his classical stuff is ripping. Ryan, yes. Get mushy with Ashley. Ashley got so fluttered she couldn't type right. Well, I'm just saying, Michael, you know he did go to Juilliard, right? So before he discovered any rock or progressive, he was getting his degree at Juilliard. He got his degree at Juilliard. I think the dude's pretty crazy. As a classic pianist, by the way. Barrel. I just, you know, if I ever did have a lovemaking session with her, I hope she wouldn't make some of those. But I know she's doing that for performance. yeah, so it's hard. I'll be quite honest. It's hard for me, which is probably why she has the, like, sexual whatever modeling thing to go along with the classical thing. Is if it weren't for that, she's going to miss out a whole bunch of people that would never listen to this music. Because for me, classical piano is pretty, but like, I don't get it. Do you know what I mean? Like, in the sense that I'm not like, I would be easy, to me it's background music. So to listen to that and like try to pay attention to it is not like something that would be, I would do. And I wouldn't get it. So the fact that she adds the visual of her beautiful legs and whatever definitely makes it more worthwhile for me to listen to it. So, yeah. And I'm speaking probably for a lot of people that don't. I think she did. I think it's a good. Whoever. It's probably not just her. It's probably like whoever's helping her market herself. It's a great, like, way to bring in people that wouldn't normally listen to this or take the time to listen to this. So it's kind of like, you know, you got your negatives and your positives for each side. It is a lovely piece, I would agree, but for background music for me. It doesn't get me, it doesn't like wake me up kind of thing, like, you know, other music would. I would be interested to see if there ever was a classical song that could like pull out major emotion for me. Because every classical song I've heard that I can remember or that's on my mind is like, oh, it's pretty, very lovely, cute, pretty, but that's about it. There's like no kind of emotion attached to it. I would love to see if there was a song that just got me like totally enveloped with it. Hasn't happened yet that I know of. So, all right, well, that brings us to 1 hour and 5 minutes because of the stupid shutdown, and now we're showing red again. It was green for the rest of that part, so I don't know. Maybe YouTube heard me complaining because I don't think it's my internet. If it was my internet, I wouldn't be able to go to other pages, and I was able to go to other pages. So I don't know. Now it's saying the stream sucks. So let's end it at that before the stream stops. And we will see you guys tomorrow night for questions. Make sure you ask your questions, as I said at the beginning. And I will try to answer them as much as we can tomorrow night and have a good time. And then we'll probably have more of a conversation than me just answering questions. I will do that, but I will probably ask some follow-up questions. So be ready. All right. You guys have a great Sunday, as I will. And we will see you guys tomorrow night. Peace out.